Comrade President Dr. Hemalatha, our esteemed leaders of fraternal trade unions, distinguished guests, special invitees, delegates, friends, brothers and sisters, I convey my warm greetings to you all. It is indeed a tremendous honor for CITU Tamil Nadu State Committee to host the 16th Conference of CITU, the highest forum of our organization. We thank our All India Committee for entrusting this responsibility with us. We are hosting CITU All India Conference at Chennai for the third time. Earlier, All India Conferences were held in 1979 and 2003 in Chennai. During the British Raj, Madras Presidency, comprised of Southern India, including the present-day Indian states of Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh, and parts of Karnataka, Kerala, and Odisha, a strong sense of national awakening emerged in the Madras Presidency. We are proud to say that the Presidency has a rich tradition of freedom struggles and trade union movement. A series of democratic struggles was launched for reorganization of states on a linguistic basis. All sorts of oppressions, caste, women, feudal, were widely prevalent in this Presidency. There were many social reformers and fighters mobilized to people to fight against all sorts of superstitions and obscurantistic ideas. To name a few in that are Siddhars, Ramalinga Adigalar, Narayana Guru, Ayodhidasar, Vaikunda Swami, Basavanna, Sagajananda, Veera Kesalinga Bandulu, and great nationalistic poet Bharatiyar and Periyar in Tamil Nadu. Of course, the role of veteran communist leaders like Krishna Pillai, EMS, A.K. Gopalan, P. Sundaraya, B. Srinivasarav, M. Singaravelar, P. Ramamurthy, Jeevanandam, and others were phenomenal. In the Presidency, there were high spirits of freedom struggle. In the independence struggle, V.O. Chidambaram Pillai launched the first indigenous Indian shipping service as a part of Swadeshi movement, which gave a new dimension to the freedom struggle. He was a lawyer and he also mobilized workers to form trade unions. In 1908, when Tilakar was arrested, he led workers' strike. That was the first political strike of the workers in South India. The reformist movement and independence struggles gave the momentum for the formation of first trade union in 1918, subsequently AITUC in 1920. This Madras Labour Union started in Bindi Mills, Barnatic and Carnatic Mills, was also a big political force. 2 days strike was organized by this union in 1921. And for that, founder of that union, B.P. Wadia, was fined by court. That evoked strong reactions all over India and Britain as well. That incident ultimately led to the enactment of Trade Union Act 1926. The first ever May Day observance by hoisting red flag in India was carried out in the city of Chennai by Comrade Singaravelar in the year 1923. In the struggle for 8 hours job, 7 comrades were shot dead in Puducherry, erstwhile French colony. In Coimbatore, for demanding trade union rights, 4 comrades were hanged. In this way, there were many struggles and sacrifices for trade union and collective bargaining rights. After independence, in 1952 first general elections, left parties became the main opposition in the Legislative Assembly. Our founder, General Secretary Comrade P. Ramamurthy, became the leader of the opposition. Our comrades spoke in Tamil, Telugu, and Malayalam in the assembly to impress upon to make all languages as official languages. They are the pioneers to raise the nationality question and strove hard to address it in a democratic way. The working class struggles for the rights and the issues organized by the left was phenomenal. In 1956, Tamil Nadu was formed. The demand for change of name to Tamil Nadu from Madras Presidency, Madras Province, was raised in the assembly and outside by the left. In the struggle for changing the name as Tamil Nadu, Sankaralinganar went on fast and died. There were massive struggles for trade union democracy and associate with their choice of union. These struggles were led by left trade union leaders that created great impact on left ideology and trade union movement. After prolonged struggles and sacrifices, trade union democracy was achieved in big factories. One factory, one union was also established. We are proud to claim that in Chennai and its suburbs, our red flag is advancing in establishing trade union and collective bargaining rights despite attacks and trade unions on trade unions and victimizations by multinational companies. The excavations at Keeladi, the Vaihai River Valley, unearthed the early and big civilization existed even during 6th century BCE. The land with ancient history, the land which witnessed glorious freedom struggles, the land which witnessed historic workers' struggles, welcomes you all. On behalf of the entire toiling masses of the state of Tamil Nadu, I welcome you all. Comrade, we have made arrangements to the extent possible for the convenience of all delegates. If any shortcomings are there, we request you to bear with us. Thank you all. I welcome you all.